most guitarists write most skilled guitarists write scaly songs.
Thank you.
So. Do, re, mi, fa, so, la. Six is la. So, in order to harmonize with that note, and as soon as we find the chords to this song, we're going to give an example of a scaly melody. The reason I'm making this vid is because when we listen to popular songs on the radio, like for instance, he's climbing the mountain, and he's an Indian looking in the water inside. This is the fire that sits in the ocean. John Zimmer song, right? Dum 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 dum. Now let's get back to the other melody. What was that melody? Some of the notes in it that I remember. John Denver song, they stick with us. They stick with us. Like, you could just name the song to a person, and all of a sudden, they haven't listened to it for years. You just name the song to the person, and all of a sudden, they're like, oh, yeah, I know how that song goes. I like that song. It's a good song. They'll just sing it right back to you, man. And they haven't even heard the song for years. Why? Now we're getting into the ingredients that make memorable songs, memory builders. Now this is going beyond the scope of music. This is getting to the root of music, memory. Ah, memory. telling me that music is nothing but memory development? Oh my God. That was Aveda, by the way. That was brand new, in the moment, now revelation. Most of my videos are like that. This is a 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. Those are the only notes that we're using. 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4. 6, 7, 6, 3, 2, 1, 7, 7, 6, 3, 2, 1, 7. Oh, we do have some other notes. 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6. 6, 7, 1. Now I call 7 Sev. Because all the other numbers have 1, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So when we're singing the melodies, 6, 7, 1, 6, 7, 6. We're only singing one note. 6, 7, 6. If we were to do it like this, 6, 7, it would be played like this. 6, 7, 7, 7. But it's not. It's 6, 7, 6, 3, 2, 1, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 6. Now we could do that as a substitution right there, because we're playing 2 7 notes in a row. start feeling healthy. But if there's nothing but plastic to smell, so, remember, melodies have breathing room in them. I see him. Hey, Randy, what's happening? Thank you. Now, getting back to my point, I added another point to it, but my point is, when the notes are breathing, then we can decorate the note with scales. This is what separates Yngwie Malmsteen from all the rest of the musicians. It's the melodies that drive the memory. Travel billions of light years in a split pea second. So, when substitution, which is another side street that we can take to smell the flowers. Not a street, but a path. A dirtly path, something on earth. Lead to water. This is what sets Ewe Momstein. It's such a pleasant ear to hear. Because he knows how to use scales to decorate melodies. What that note is. Here it is. That's the pickup note. So it goes like this. I'm starting to like this guitar because that note comes up all, as I heard that note for the first time in one of my videos, the latest video that I just made. It's very pleasing. It just jumped its way right in there, universally. Melody. Remember, we're developing our memories. See what I'm doing? I'm decorating the melodic note that's being held. Decoration. Decorate during the melodic note when it's held. Is that so? As it's being held, we can quickly decorate it with scales. I would call that a counterpoint scale. Now remember, we can also decorate a melodic note being held with a counterpoint melody. And there's two different types of scales. There's a scale sounding scale, and there's a melodic sounding scale. This would be a scale sounding scale. This would be a melodic sounding scale. What differentiates a scalotic sounding scale from a melodic sounding scale? A scalotic sounding scale is one note played right after the other in succession, like this. Out of the net. I like it like that. That's the fifth string, so I have to push it back and spot it down. I use it as my checkpoint to keep myself from burning up. It slows me down. It's a forceful tool. A tool of force. Now, I scale. I would call that the female brain, which is the lower brain, the cerebellum, which is Goliath in the Bible. I'll get you! And David was the male-female of the brain. He was, I'll get you! But his I'll get you was for justice. Goliath's I'll get you was for domination. Once you have all the understanding down, you can scribble. You can go through life scribbling, man. And just wait for all the rest of the people to enter into understanding. That's why you see Bay Momstein up on the stage just scribbling all night. He has a high level of understanding about music and other things. And he's waiting for everybody else to climb the mountain. The mountain of pleasantry. Pleasantry. Because life is all about feeling good. So that we can trigger this memory. It's all rooted in the same word. It means sun. It means life, eternal life. That's the Latin of everything. The Latin of melody, memory, is sun. Sun, which is eternal life. Sun is just life. Life eternal. It's the root. Everything's living. It's alive. There's no mention of anything else. Just life. The only thing that we mention is life. Life. We only put life before our eyes. This is why a goat can stand on the edge of a cliff, a vertical cliff, and climb a vertical cliff. Because all he thinks of is, I'm safe, I'm peaceful, I live. Melody. Decoration. Melody. Breathing note. Thank you. Then I'll get you back to my point. Melodic scales. Scale. Scale is female of the lower brain, called the cerebellum. This is Goliath. Total domination. Total disregard for peace. Total disregard for sharing. Total disregard for sharing. He has his mind on death. Oh, believe me, brothers and sisters, there's a day coming. We won't even mention the word death no more. Just like a goat, a mountain goat, climbing his rocks on the cliff. 1,000-foot drop before him. He doesn't even think about death. Now, that's because he's risen up to the male part of the upper brain called the cerebrum. Melody. That right there is a melodic scale. A scale does not have any breath in it. A melodic scale has more breath in it than a scalotic scale, though. And if we hold a note, changing keys, off notes, but that's another side path. We can smell the aroma with that one a little later on, but is that so? Play Malmsteen's, how to play guitar like Malmsteen, don't they? Come on, shake your heads, yes. is it that the driving force of all the guitar players on the earth play heavy metal music? Why is it that they're all playing 100,000 million miles of notes per hour? But yet there's no memorable melodies to recall from them. It's because they're striving to discover that which Mr. Malmsteen has already discovered. And they're gonna get there! It's just that they need some compost.
Thank you.
what sent everybody racing to the woodshed back in the early 80s. It was like, how do we write like that? How do we play like that? It must be because he plays fast. That's only half the truth. It's only half the truth. Plays like that because he understands melody. And until I talk to him personally, find out if he really does. But I can tell because he has not written any other songs in the past 30 years that even comes close to his Black Star song. That tells me that he doesn't fully understand. That song from pure instinct. There's a difference between instinct and knowing. The upper brain, the lower brain. Say a mix between female and male because The female goes straight scales. If we're doing this, it's a female melody from the Most High, known as the Cerebrum. It's the Most High up here. This is where the Temple of Solomon is, the Ark of the Covenant, known as the Third Eye. Inner Eye. Inner Ear. It's the ear that we follow. It's the music that we hear. Thank you. infested onto the neck of the guitar. This music is a manifestation. This is female. The Ark of the Covenant is male. It's invisible. It's cause. This is effect. Universal law. It's philosophic alchemy. Thank you. like that John Denver song.
Thank you.
lot of decorating in there. Scholastic decoration. A mix of male-male decoration. A mix of male-female decoration. A mix of... I didn't put any female-females in there. Female-female is this. One note in succession right after the other. Pure scale, man. It's pure female. Pure female, female part of the brain, the lower brain, female brain. Remember, when you rub your philosopher's stone, everything has polarity. Two poles, negative and positive. There's two parts to everything. It's a better way of putting it. When you're learning your lessons from Santos Banaki in astrology, it'll show you how there's two sides of the male and there's two sides of the female. Because the male has two components in it, which is fire and air. Those are the two male sides of the male. The two female sides of the female is water and earth. Cancer and Capricorn. Way Momstein, just play man. Ways of Cancer, just play man's a Capricorn. Because the lower brain is called female, and it has has two sides, earth and water. So the brain itself, the cerebellum, is female, represents female. Water and earth represent female. So there you have your trinity. That's your trust. That's your triangle. It's called the triple crown. Female, female, female. This is female, female, female. As the sun sets, and the sun rises, and it's at its highest point called Cancer. This is Ingwe Malmsteen. It represents the highest point. Cancer is the zodiacal sign. Cancer is not illness. It's not sickness, it's not disease. Cancer is just the highest point of the sun. Capricorn is the mountain goat. It likes to climb to the top. That would be this. Ascension, that's the male female in the lower brain. Scale, these are scales. Scales. One note played in the succession, right after the other. If we were to do this, that would be the male of the female brain, because the tree represents a break in the synchronicity. Break in the order. Just the term by itself, female scalotic, female scale, one note after the other. Yeah. smell the aroma. If we're not stopping on the smell and the aroma, then we're not getting that kundalini rise up the serpentine. That holy oil, David represents the anointing, the eternal oil. We get that kundalini serpentine. Rise, because that's the oil that's going to give us our eternal life when we learn to rest. Thank you. this right here is scale. The note being held is melody. If I was to go continue with the scale and go, that's pure scale, man. That was pure female, 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 triple female scale right there. That was pure water, earth, from the lower brain, cerebell. But I went, thank you. play it, share it. Create your own world with it.
Thank you.
6, known as the A note. Those are two of the same notes right there, one octave apart. There's another E. There's a higher E. There's a higher E. Third note in the key of C. And C is the key that we're playing the song in. Is that so? Makes me kinda wonder. Is it so? Could it be? Could it be a melody? A melody? Is that so? So while we're holding the note, six note in the key of C.
Do a dare, female dear, a drop of golden sun. Be a knee, a knee, to come up.
Fuck,
I'm a looking at red. So, a needle and some thread. Be a note to come up. La, a note to follow some. So, a needle and some thread.
Hertz, 440. This is 880. An octave, all you gotta do is multiply it times 2. 440 times 2 is 880. 880 is 1600 and something. Times 3, because that's the third octave. 1 octave, 2 octave times 2. Octave times 3. 440 times 3, or 880 times 2, 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 440 times 3. Decorated. Da, da, da. Hold that note, decorate. Hold that note times 3. Decorate that note. Decorate that. This is a lick right there. And then hit it twice. Slide it down like Iron Maiden. Dave Murray. as a Capricorn too, you know? Sixth note. Melody. Remember the melody. Let's get the melody again.
Is that so? Makes me kind of want to. Makes me kind of want to give. Want to share. Want to tell a melody. Is that so?
Number six chord. Number six chord is made of three notes. Those three notes played individually are called arpeggios, and if we play those notes individually as a chord, it would be an A6 chord and an E3 chord, because E's the third note in that number six arpeggio called the A6 arpeggio. Harmonizing chord for that being held. Note being held. Note being held. Note being held. Melody. Melody. New melody. A new melody. See how music works? Okay, so back to the original melody.
Is that so?
That note's being held. That note's being held so we can play our chord with it. Alright, so we're going to find a third and final chord, and then we're going to end this lesson. So, here's Here's the original melody.
Is that so? Makes me wanna wonder. Is that so?
Let's find the other note to the A6 arpeggio.
Is that so?
So we have to put that in our mind. That one note's being held. Six F, six. Six is being held. So now we found the three chords that we can play along with that melodic note that's being held. Is that so? Is that so? There's the A. Is that so? This is classical guitar right here. See this? So, there's the C, played with the 6, is that so, there's the 6, played with the 6, is that so, there's the E, played with the A6.
Sing the note first, then play the chord. Is that
that so? I say that for beginners. Is that so? Sing the note first, then play the chord. Arpeggio it. We're picking each individual note. This is an arpeggio now. Strumming is chords. I'm playing chords. Is that so? 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 Six. Okay. That's 2 hours and 20 minutes of entertaining, get down with your clown lesson. Talk to you later. I love you all.
I love you all, as Ozzy likes to say. I love you all! Hot for words!
Hey. I learned this from Hot for Words. I learned this from Hot for Words and Ozzy.
I love you all!
Azazio likes to say we should talk later. Let me get my composure here. Zero looks like Michael Sweet. Look at that. From a distance. Uh-oh. Oh, here's Kim Tamplin in here. Kim? Need your help. Kim's like,
yeah, I know.
I know, man. I know. Sing it, Michael.
Together as one.
Come on, Robert. Get on them toms. Let's get down on that fox and basses. What's the basses? Oh. Every one of these cats. It's just that me and this particular cat. Ozzy has a special bond with Captain. Gonna click whenever, gonna click.